Welcome to Take 5, a podcast brought to you by Newleaf Training and Development. Each edition is an inspiring interview with a leader worth listening to. Enjoy.
Hey, I'm Paul Butler. I'm one of the client partners at Newleaf Training and Development, and I'm delighted to be joined today by James McKenna, who is a consultant, speaker, and author at McKenna Learning. James, can you believe it? For nearly 17 years now at Newleaf, we focused on our core purpose of helping people and organizations better manage themselves, lead others, and grow business acumen. I just wondered, what are your recommended best practices to help people and organizations be their best? But please do start, though, by telling us a little bit more about your organization, what you do, and who you serve. So over to you, James, and I'll wrap it up when you're done.
Thanks, Paul. And I'm so glad to be part of this. You know, at McKenna Learning, my job is to work with folks in the field and say, okay, how do we help people learn better and then, of course, perform better on their jobs? And I do that by leveraging a research-based framework called Universal Design for Learning that comes out of the K-12 education space, but is really about the science of how people learn and what motivates them. And I recently wrote a book called Upskill, Reskill, Thrive that helps take UDL and apply it to workspace learning. But I don't want to go through the whole tenets of the book and all those other things. I wanted to key in on one particular mindset that I think is really important no matter where you sit in the learning and performance space, and that's ownership. Hmm. Taking ownership of that learning and performance improvement effort. Now, that's something that doesn't always come easy. I mean, it comes easy when the performance is going great and they look at what I did and everybody's improving. But when learning is stuttering and performance suffers, sometimes we look around and say, well, you know, I did my part. And, you know, those of us in L&D might say, well, you know, we might blame the managers or we might blame the learners. I taught the stuff. They should have gone out and done it. Or the managers are supposed to be doing this. It's out of my control. And so when that happens and if performance suffers, well, maybe you're right. Some of that's out of your control and maybe the learners could take better ownership of their process. But when you have poor performance, managers and learners might get some negatives on their evals, but guess whose budget's getting cut? Probably yours. So I like to think about how you can take greater ownership of that end-to-end learning process and address what you can control and then try to influence what you can't. And it starts with having this mindset that barriers to learning exist in the environments, not in the people. And those environments might be those designed environments that you create, might also be where the people are doing the learning, right? And where they're applying that learning to the work. So address what you can control and influence what you can't. Start by becoming the management's best friend. How do you help them better understand how what you do helps them reach what they already want? It makes them look good. It makes their teams feel good and everybody wins. And then think about for yourself, the things that you can control. I'm not saying you have to blow up everything overnight. You know, there are always better ways that we can support learning. And that's a long road. But there's a great first step that I describe, and it comes from a guy named Thomas J. Tobin, and I talk about it in my book, and he talks about himself. It's called plus one approach. We don't always have time to recreate a whole e-learning module or a two-day workshop, but we do have time to fix one thing. So we take a learning environment and experience that we've delivered before and we're going to deliver again, and based on what we know about our people, where do we figure the biggest pinch point is? Where do the most eyes glaze over? What do people most miss on the assessment? What fails to transfer into practice most often? And think about, okay, what's going on there? Is it going too fast? Is the process not clear? Is the value proposition not compelling enough for people to put into practice? What is the one, what's behind it? What is the barrier? And then think about, okay, what's one thing that I could do? What could I add? What could I tweak? What can I subtract from this experience that may mitigate or eliminate that barrier? And then go do that and then deliver it again and see how it goes. And deliver it with intentionality. Don't give up halfway, but really give it a chance and see how that goes. And talk to your learners and see how it worked for them. And over time, changing one thing, we get faster at it. Soon plus one can become plus two, plus three. Mm-hmm. And we really start to anticipate when we have time to design something from scratch. We've got a whole bunch of experience of these small wins of getting things out of the way of our people and helping them learn and do their best. Mm-hmm. And so I think that's a great first step for taking greater ownership of learning in your organization.
Mm. James, I really love the clarity and the practical summation that you did there. And I just want to give a quick plug out. I didn't intend to do this, but James's book that he referred to there, I would personally highly recommend that. James, give us the title again.
Oh, it's Upskill, Reskill, Thrive, Optimizing Learning and Development in the Workplace from Cass Publishing.
Excellent. Well, just a message out to the subscribers to keep an eye on the events page of our website, where we have many free professional development events on a regular basis. Most of those are free to subscribers. And James, I just want to say again, a big thank you for taking a few minutes with us today. Could I offer you a virtual high five? Thanks again, James, and I look forward to seeing you soon.
Thanks, everyone.
I hope you found that interview useful, and if you did, feel free to rate, review, and share this podcast. We'll be back next week with another episode, and we also invite you to check out our other weekly podcast, Going the Extra Mile, which is sure to lift your spirit and encourage you in today's working world. Bye for now.